We shall learn how to create a database using SQL Server Compact. So our objective is to learn how to create a database because we generally need it in our projects, and let us now see. SQL Server Compact is a database which is very small in size. It can hold relatively large amounts of data with a very small file size. There are certain disadvantages. You cannot have stored procedures in this. I see this is the only one disadvantage. Otherwise, it is very easy to deploy. Just copy the file to your project. If you want to upload it to a web server, you have to just copy the SQL Server Compact file to the web server. So backups are easy. You can change it anytime. You don't have to go through the process of writing complex queries. I have always found it handy in my projects, and let us see how to create a database using SQL Server Compact. So this is a basic MVC app that we have created. It doesn't have any controllers, models. So right click here and click add new item. In the left pane you can see Visual C Sharp, choose data. And in this list you will find SQL Server Compact 4.0 or maybe 3.5 depending on the version you have. And you can make a selection here. So give it any name. We are giving it name DB Registration. And click Add. It says you are attempting to add a special type SDF. The extension is SDF. To an ASP.NET website, in general to use this type of item, you should place it in app underscore data. Yes, we'll place it in app underscore data because it is secure also. Click yes. Clicking yes will immediately add certain references for the DLLs. And then if you see your app underscore data, you will find the SDF file. This SDF file along with these DLLs can be copied. These DLLs can be copied to your bin folder, and this database can be copied to app underscore data, and the entire thing starts working. Now how do we add tables? This is under Solution Explorer. Visual Studio automatically picks up any database file under app underscore data and will show you it under Database Explorer. Click Data Connections and you will find your database appearing here. Click this one. Tables and Replication Subscriptions. So these are a bit of off-the-line topics. We are worried about tables right now. Right click Create Table. You will find this type of a view. It might not be appearing completely on this window, but it will be whatever is visible, you can make it out. So I'll give it a name TBL Registration. So I've given the name Registration and just click on this column once, and I'll give it name ID. Here I can choose the data type. I choose it to be int. So data types appropriate for SQL are available here. Allow nulls, yes. Unique, no. Actually I want it to be a primary key, so I'll click on yes. The moment I click yes here, this automatically turns to no, and this automatically turns to no. So unique is actually an index that can be made against a column, as you already know from your SQL. Since it is already a primary key, the index will always be there automatically. No separate index needs to be added. We might also want this index to be